margin for error now with Amir Harris, the most recent Cornhusker to go to the bench with an injury.
And the 2019 Big Ten Men's Basketball Tournament is underway from the United Center.
Arroyo
skips to Harper. And Harper knocks down the mid-range jumper.
Nice job by Harper.
Hardly has, Sean. Last seven games, 14 a contest for Harper. How about Thor Bjarnason?
Oh, Reykjavik is going nuts right now.
They're tuned in. Baker in the lane, out to Mathis. And Mathis, it's a two, his foot was on the line. So Baker hits after being one of his last 16 in the final week of the season. Good finish at the rim by James Palmer.
It's like they were down the stretch versus Iowa, what we've seen here so far.
Baker, high arcing from the free throw line. Miles Johnson, the freshman, up the window.
I really like the development of this young guy.
Obi misses.
Same play. The only difference was rather than Palmer keeping it, he slipped it to Roby.
Omaruyi on the feed from Montez Mathis. Timeout, Nebraska. Caleb McConnell still out there, number 22 in white, after picking up his second foul. And a nice three-point shot by Glenn Watson.
Good job by Roby.
But Omaruyi, a better job offensively. Yeah, it's tough at 6'10", 250 to catch that head to the basket. On the way to the basket, Glenn Watson for two. Omaruyi showing a little range. That left it open, Watson. Roby.
Nice.
Well, Roby hasn't scored, but there he contributes with a rebound and an assist. The first assisted field goal of the night for Nebraska. Omaruyi. Well, now he's feeling comfortable with that mid-range. Baker, patient, has it stripped. Watson, one of the top steel men of the conference, and he takes it to the other end.
How about the play by Watson of sensing that Omaruyi, the post feed was there?
Yeah, because you would think he doesn't need that. He's so much bigger than Hyman. Oh, tap back by the aforementioned Brady Hyman.
And 9 points off those turnovers for the Cornhuskers. Nice feed.
And Roby with his first basket.
What a play out of the dead ball situation.
Glenn Watson, great feed. Hyman over the top of the rim for two. And his head on the sideline as well. Baker over the top to Johnson. And Johnson stops the drought and ties us back up. A different shot in game clock. Palmer off the window for a pair. Dorsett, the lone senior, missing. There's McConnell that you mentioned. He puts it back in and the foul. Crappy hands. McConnell almost traveled, kicks it out to Harper, and he buries it.
Yep, someone's going to have to shoot over the top.
Omaruyi spinning away from the double team, and Roby is down. He twisted his left ankle, I think.
Momentarily. Oh, boy, they got Miles Johnson. Wide open.
Omaruyi saw it. Johnson slams them both up. And now, five on the shot clock. Right to the rim, James Palmer.
Assert himself.
And I know he's just one of nine from the field, but he's a key cog in that wheel. Omaruyi with a tough finish.
Nice cut.
And Watson finishes it.
Really nice job of moving without the basketball.
Field Baker out to McConnell. McConnell had it stripped by Borkart. Took it right to him. And now Palmer. That is a tough finish in traffic. Here comes the double. Shot clock at three. Harper from the elbow. Yes.
Nice job by Ron Harper Jr. of not panicking with the shot clock ready to expire.
Backcourt McConnell. Nice. Kicks it out. How about Carter sticking it back? Watson kicking it out to Palmer. How about Palmer? He's got 12 of Nebraska's 14 points this half. McConnell with the answer on the other end. Both teams identical from outside the arc, 2 of 10. Palmer, what a half he's having.
Watson's played a long time with that third foul, Brandon. Nice look off.
Johnson powering it up over Roby. Now has 9. Watson to the corner. How about True Blood? He says, yeah, I'm a walk-on, but I can play out here. Omaruyi. What a feed and what a stop by Miles Johnson. By Auto Owners Insurance.
Well, he's also accomplished off the floor as an engineering major, and two of the factors in an academic discipline coming into play here. Pass and force sent in by Miles Johnson for Auto Owners Insurance.
Roby out to True Blood. Shot clock to Wendling. Roby! Just before the buzzer sound. How about they picked up that bad third personal, but he's been able to control himself since. Step back three, you can't lead. James Palmer open. Looking to add to a 9-0 run. Roby, right to the rim.
The shot fake throws Rutgers defensively, able to turn the corner.
Rutgers hasn't scored in over 4 minutes, a bad time for that drought. Johnny Trueblood swatted. Good block by Harper. Maruyi works his way back under.
The pass.
Gets it back and swatted by Roby.
After he blocked the shot, the officials tell him to tone it down.
Palmer read the telegraph pass and throws it down, and the foul is wild, and they're going to say that's a flagrant.
Understanding the scouting report is James Palmer. Now watch the forearm in the back. You're up in the air. You're defenseless. I think that's a pretty clear cut. Number five in the back while he's in the air, a defensive player. Good job by the officials of not only seeing it, but watch what they do. They come in between before anything.
Omaruyi trying to back down Roby.
Good job by Roby.
Left leg, he wasn't able to get any kind of lift
from that dislocated kneecap earlier in the season. Baker, boy, did they need that.
Been saddled with three fouls and, you know, maybe get something going toward the basket with the clock stopped.
Well, here you go, and it's Baker right to the rim. They need points in a hurry.
And the guy's active hands again, and yet another turnover.
And Palmer with a finish. 42, the most points ever scored by a Cornhusker in the Big Ten tournament. Baker with the answer. Convert. And Rutgers watching the final seconds tick away. Peter Kiss banks it in. And how about Nebraska? They come into the Big Ten tournament with six scholarship players, and they use a 15-0 run late in the second half to win over the Scarlet Knights 68-61. Big Ten, this is the 178th meeting between Northwestern and Illinois, and off we go from Chicago in that second defender on occasion. Here's Bishanishvili. Around Parton, the freshman taking it to the senior. Again, no Vic Law with that right leg injury sustained against Purdue, so they're going to need guys like Anthony Gaines to step up. Four for the Fighting Illini.
And here's that pressure.
But they beat the pressure, and if you do, you get baskets like that.
So, this Illinois pressure.
Nice pass. Bishanishvili, nice spin, splitting the defenders. Nice. Over the top, Bishanishvili. He's got six.
And a really good job by Bishanishvili of riding the defender up the lane. That provided the angle.
Police, great pass. Bishanishvili scores it and the foul. He has all eight for the Fighting Illini.
Well, to push the pace, then how about the delivery? The shot fake, you take the contact, a chance for an and one.
So Bishanishvili nine and Northwestern four. And boy, that was almost a nickel steal. Northwestern needed that bucket by Derek Hart. I'm taking MJ all day for whatever that's worth. Around the arc to foul zone, and he knocks it down. Of his last 38 prior to that make.
Good. Oh, what a court awareness!
And Bishanishvili scores it to Sumo.
Not panicking, right here. Keeps his feet in bounds, does not panic, and then he has the presence of mind not just to get it back into the field of play. They can't lose sight of foul zone here in the far corner.
Miller Kopp, that's a tough shot.
I like the future for that guy. Shot by foul zone of holding down the fourth till Parton could get there.
Bishanishvili, he's got 14. runner. A.J. Turner off the foul zone. Now Cobb stepping back. Three. Yes.
Good job by Northwestern of keeping Illinois exclusively behind the arc here.
Well, Frazier from 5 feet behind the arc.
The job Underwood did, giving up a ton of size to Nance.
And he's just 6'2", and Nance 6'10". Woo! Nice finish by Anthony Gay. Frazier dancing inside.
And a nice job by Bashaunas Vili of wheeling off.
38 from the line for Illinois. That was the difference of the five-point victory.
And the guy with the ball, Felice, was 16 of 17.
This time, Felice with the assist to his teammate Aaron Jordan. Nance inside the top. The two freshmen connect. Yeah, you said it. He's going to be a heck of a player the next 3 years for Chris Collins. Bashaunas Vili. Well, he hadn't scored in 5 minutes, but now he has 16 points. Barton is going to dial it from deep, and it drops down. Only the sixth three-pointer he's made all year. A.J. Turner does it all himself. Vili.
And that bad numbers. Nice job, though, of backpedaling by Northwestern.
Felice reverses course for two. Time report coming up with Dave, John, and Andy. Final minute 18. Felice with the last four for the Fighting Illini. Around the arc. Into Bashaunas Vili. And it deadens off the back of the rim. Vili. Harden spins and scores it. Illinois lucky that they don't have two turnovers already this half. In rhythm three, A.J. Turner.
Gaines was able to recover.
And give Bashaunas Vili 20. Turner. Yes, he's heating up. And he gives Northwestern their first lead of the game. And then DeSumo with his first basket of the game takes that lead right back. Harden with great positioning in the slam. Turner. Northwestern is 5 of 5 for the floor this half. Harden. Oh! He thought he got fouled. Now a numbers advantage, and DeSumo takes advantage. A.J. Turner, you mentioned he's been hot from three as of late.
And he sensed that he had the mismatch with De La Rosa and took advantage.
Frazier trying to drop it off for De La Rosa, but it comes down to Parton. Now Miller, cut right to the rim. Extra pass, Taylor three, short. Got his own miss. And lays it in. He needs some help. Turner back to Vincent. And he buries the mid-range jumper. Inside Bashaunas Vili finds himself wide open.
In terms of those arms flailing around.
Felice, good kick. Frazier, got it.
Job until Martin's able to come back down and help.
Here's the matchup. Wow. The freshman does it again. He has 24.
He wasn't given the opportunity there, and then good team defense getting the ball out of Bashaunas Vili's hands.
Taylor remains cold. Harden cleans up the mess. Felice, three to shoot. Frazier, by Harden, and a little floater.
Good patience and not panicking by Frazier. Two zone look, gliding it out here.
Inside the part. Yeah, it was a great feed from Miller Cox. Steal by Bashaunas Vili. And the big man takes it coast to coast. Well, that was their first miscue in 7 minutes. Bashaunas Vili now with 26. Turner with the answer. Frazier. Takes it to the rim. Belize blocked by Cuff. And then Cuff fouled him, and Belize got it to go. Stays around. The loser goes home.
Remember a common foul on a dribble drive. It's a one and one.
Belize drives. Got it blocked. 1.2 to go. It stays with Illinois. They have no timeout.
Nance in there to provide an obstacle for the inbound. Oh, boy, wide open.
Right into Belize, but it's blocked near the rim. And we have overtime at the United Center. Tough on the catch. Well, Harden somehow kept it and kicked it out to foul zone for three. He's going to work. Kicks it out. Free to shoot. Jordan, tough runner.
Gordon on Derek Harden.
And then Belize almost lost it. Kicked it to Frazier for the three. Could we have a 13th lead change? No. Great block by Nasumu. Frazier, extra pass. Nasumu got it. Harden out to Turner.
Ooh, almost a steal.
Foul zone. Yes. That stops the 8-0 run.
Good job right there by Turner moving his feet.
Belize with two on the shot clock. He puts it off the window. Turner. No. And that'll do it. It took overtime, but Illinois outlasts Northwestern 74-69.
It is Ohio State, Indiana right now, and a ton of NCAA tournament implications perhaps, and here we go. Ohio State will control the tip. Romeo Langford's first try is a good one. Defensively, he has been stellar since his return, most notably on Cassius Winston in that big home win versus Michigan State. Keyshawn Woods, little turnaround, his body's hit the deck below him. Indiana was picked preseason third in the Big Ten. It's been a disappointing year as Andre Wesson, a nice little mid-range.
Watch the West Coast Conference, St. Mary's snatching up the automatic berth, bumping Gonzaga down into an at-large berth. There's a lot of moving parts as this thing unfolds.
Coming back from Achilles surgery last year, dealt with an illness as well. He gives him some great spot minutes, able to score with a left hand. Devontae Green's been so good lately for the Hoosiers, misses his first chance. Here's Weston again, he'll fire another three, and he'll knock this one down. Tennessee probing. Green. Got it. Rattles it home. It's a good combination with the two guards out there together in Tennessee and Green. Davis banging his way in. Davis, a couple of moves, had it stripped. That's Luther Muhammad on the floor for the first time. He gets a steal. Gives it up. Washington. Got it. New clock for Ohio State. Caleb Wesson. And a foul. Counted.
To not just throw it to your teammate, but away from the defense. He threw it away from number 13, Morgan, in a place where only Wesson could get it. Catch, gather, and then a really good...
What a way to get our day started here on BTN. The Hoosiers and the Buckeyes of Ohio State as Morgan goes strong, gets the friendly bounce.
Bad pass by Wesson. No way that thing was going to get through.
Here's Green now. Green leaps it up. And the floater is good. Langford's camping down in the corner. Bullet pass inside. Right on cue, Sean. No room for a pass there for Green. It's a turnover. Andre Wesson. Got it.
Well, nice help there by Wesson to help his younger brother.
Morgan just turned it over, threw it right in the hands of Muhammad. Keyshawn Woods up and over Morgan. Four steals for the Buckeyes. They have 9 points off turnovers. And a five-point lead with 7:45 remaining in the first. Al Durham goes, scores it, and a foul.
Little dribble handoff, and they're able to get Durham going to a strong or left job on the far side by Morgan. I'm not letting Wesson get his body into him.
Justin Smith returns as well. In the front court with Morgan. This is Woods. Made the 1 3-pointer early. Does have a couple of rebounds. Into the hands of Morgan. He goes and he finishes. He was under the backboard. Able to score it on the Wesson brothers.
Go up there with two hands and finish.
Tie game at 22. Keyshawn Woods knocks it down. Delivered the contact and then made the jump. Young. Working on Thompson. Oh, rattles it down. Strong move.
Both starting bigs, Morgan for Indiana and Caleb Wesson for the Buckeyes on the bench right now.
Another three is up. Andre Wesson knocks it down. Just the third three-point make for the Buckeyes.
Right, if you're Indiana, you have to get something going toward the rim, preferably with Romeo Langford maybe coming off a little bit of a screen.
Langford gives it up. Green for three. Ooh. The answer. Indiana had a lead at 3-2. That's been their only lead. Ohio State hasn't been able to pull away. What a block by Al Durham. And then the other end, Langford working on Jackson. No whistle. Ohio State looking to run. Excellent defense. Caleb Wesson got it. Big man running the floor. Green for three. Big bucket for Devontae Green.
Swing the ball and probe both sides of the floor. Quick shot leads to an opportunity.
Turnover Green. Kick it up ahead. Washington. That's Jackson with a quick catch and finish. Comes Woods. Trying to turn the corner. Langford with him. And Woods. Up and over. Langford. Wow, with some skill in that one. Veteran move from the grad transfer.
Back down the freshman. And look, they cleared out that entire side of the floor. All the other white jerseys are on the left side to allow Keyshawn Woods able to play more effectively in longer stretches than I might have imagined after being out for three games. Yes, he could condition, but it's a whole lot different than playing in a Big Ten basketball game and doing a nice job.
This is a huge game for NCAA tournament implications for both. They are sitting in very similar positions. CJ Jackson for three!
That three and the one he missed earlier was the extension on the follow-through.
Answer, Devontae Green. Ohio State ball.
Oh, nice hesitation.
Jackson all the way in with a finger roll. The fact you get winded so easily has nothing to do with the altitude.
Yeah, I wheezed climbing up two levels of stairs.
Here's Jackson, hits a three. Boy, lined that one up true and knocks it down. Langford, open, hits it. It's his first made basket since the first 2 minutes of the game. Tennessee, nice finish with the left hand, trying to get the tie turn. Langford, good pass, and Morgan finishing with a foul. Turnover, lost the handle. Wesson up ahead. Jackson on the run out. What a huge mistake by the Hoosiers. CJ Jackson, Jallo down inside. Caleb Wesson with the left hand. Morgan draws the foul. Count it. They've got a couple of point guards coming next year, Ohio State. They feel like that will improve significantly. Muhammad for three. Good find and finish. Three-pointer. 17 points, 12 boards. Woods knocks it down. That's his sweet spot. Keyshawn Woods. Now Woods, the best ball handler the Buckeyes have. Gives it up. Muhammad for three. Oh, big hit. Luther Muhammad. 20-point lead. Indiana over their last five. Green for three. Boy, did they need that. Romeo Langford goes to the hole, hangs another block for Wesson into the hands of Fittner. Fittner puts it back for two. Jackson's got 10 in the second half. Here's Davis, four fouls. Fittner for three, can make them from there. That would be a big lift for the Hoosiers if Fittner can get going. These eagle-eye officials today in the Big Ten. Big shot, three, got it! Indiana, climbing their way back. It's a nine-point game. Side to Davis, four fouls, draws the double, Davis turns, scores! 13-0 run for Indiana! Caleb Wesson with Davis on him, kick it, Jackson for three, got it!
Fighting the double team, and then when it's on its way, you kick it out.
22 points off Indiana turnovers for the Buckeyes. Durham, well, he was thrilled on his way to the basket, somehow scores. Buckeyes by eight with the ball. trying to withstand this Indiana run.
Woods.
Yes! He's got 14, six boards as well, and he's guarded Langford most of the game. On the take goes Durham. Bridges is there. Durham scores! They're going to have to get one up quickly, though. C.J. Jackson, be the man to put it in. And here is Woods, who's wide open and hits it!
Keyshawn Woods is a good barometer for how well Ohio State plays, and right now, if you're in Buckeye Nation, it's 75 and sunny.
Deron Davis. Deron Davis scores, and one! Each team has scored on four straight possessions. Fitchner for three. Yes! Same spot, he's at two! And it's into the hands of Green. On a breakaway, good pass. Langford, finish! Boy, Green threaded the needle with that pass on the bounce. Their go-to player. All freshman Big Ten. Langford, no. Gets it back. Langford again. Yes! Three-point game. Woods has 16 points. Just hit a big two on the take against Langford. And he hits again! Keyshawn Woods with 18. All that experience. He's handled the pressure. On the run out. Durham. Oh, couldn't get it. Washington breakaway. Throws it down with two hands. But Washington recovers and finishes. And it's back to a 7-point lead. Green, the long three. Hey! It's still alive.
You want to keep guys in front and make you go side to side, not north-south.
Langford gives it up. Green, long three again. Oh, are you kidding? He's hit another. And the Buckeyes are up four and not enough time for Indiana. They'll let him shoot it. Langford misses. That takes us to the end. The Ohio State Buckeyes snapping a three-game losing streak. Now we're set for Maryland and Nebraska. Isaiah Roby, Bruno Fernando will tip it up. It is controlled by the Terrapins. And away we go. 22-9 for the year. 13-7 in conference play. Into the corner. Morsell hits the three and has a peek at the Nebraska bench on its way back. Cowan got the mismatch on him. Finds the other mismatch. Smith, long mid-range is good. That was a sweet stroke. A couple of years here. They've got some talented underclassmen. Roby goes. Roby has it blocked. Up ahead, Cowan runs it down.
Opportunity is there, but you don't want to get in any kind of pace. You just don't have the body.
Minimal personnel. Watson for three. Got it. First made field goal for the Huskers. Bound number four for Fernando. Cowan. Wiggins had it swatted by Borchardt. Violently denied. Watson. What a play. Off the window with Smith closing out on it. Or 11, I should say. Averages 13 a game. Here's Wiggins again. Got it. That shot was true. Put it right in the pocket as well. A wide open three knocked down by Aaron Wiggins. James Palmer Jr.'s first attempt. Tough shot goes.
To disallow any opportunity to come over and block that shot on the drive.
Nice pass. Ball's moving well. Smith got it. Made it look easy. Good pass from Wiggins.
Forced Rutgers into a scramble situation defensively.
The 22 free throw attempts was a Big Ten record yesterday. Out of the timeout, three-pointer is good, and Johnny Trueblood returns the favor.
Contrasted with the Cornhuskers leading the conference in that category.
There is a turnover, the first of the game for Nebraska. Wiggins, oh my goodness! A spin and a hammer from Aaron Wiggins. Inbounds. Oh, this is another look at our BTN standout presented by Auto Owners Insurance.
Nice job by Wiggins for our BTN Auto Owners Insurance standout.
Nebraska has six scholarship players available. They have endured a ton of injuries, and Roby, his first field goal make, and it's with an exclamation point.
Plays in Nebraska's favor.
James Palmer Jr. He can do it all. He can score with the best of them. Takes the contact and one for Palmer. Cowan fakes the three on his way. Gives it up to Smith. The lob to the freshman Jalen Smith with the throwdown. Went for the shot fake. Turned into a lob. Thorborn Yarmason gives it up. Palmer for three. Got it. Oh, James Palmer Jr.
This is a pace that Nebraska wants. It's about a 50-possession pace. Thor Bjarnason with the left-handed layup coming out of the timeout. Tim. Roby, five on the shot clock. Roby with the left. Mark Turgeon calls the timeout to Friday. James Palmer Jr., he'll pull up a three. Ooh. Knocks it down. JPJ. James Palmer Jr. has 48 points on 23 shots in his turnout already. Talk about efficiency. Fernando on the take. Oh. Nice reverse and a foul. Ooh. About 5 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. Watson, the crossover. Open for the jumper. Knocks it down. Nebraska shooting it well. In our first game today, Ohio State will advance to take on Michigan State tomorrow. Here's Roby for three. Yes! Cleared away by Jalen Smith. Ayala behind the back. Nifty. And a foul. Count it! Oh, I beg your pardon. A chance at a three-point play.
Well, I tell you what, he might have gotten away a little bit with a carry.
Looked like Palmer. Palmer had a block. Fernando up ahead in transition. Marcel! Timeout, Nebraska. Point blank range. Hyman just got a little eager. And Marcel finishes with authority on the other end. And I think what Roby with nine on the shot clock. On the take, Roby. Fernando right up. Big pass and Borkart finishes. Patient and finds the open man. He's made an immediate impact. Tanner Borkart
keeping that possession alive.
Palmer, are you kidding? Are you kidding me? Oh, man. How strong do you have to be to finish that off?
And especially from the elbow dive.
Palmer goes again. A foul and counted. James Palmer Jr. Roby and Borkart up top. There's the screen. Watson. 4-3. Watson got it. Glenn Watson, essentially a four-guard lineup with Roby in the middle. Roby, couple of shot fakes. Roby follows and puts it in. Bjarnason kept it alive.
Much larger Minnesota team where they enjoyed a 36-18 points in the paint advantage.
Another opportunity for Maryland, and it's blocked by Roby. They're already. Oh, met at the rim. Fernando meets Roby and a save. By Wiggins, what a play! What a great play! And Marcel finishes with a foul! Remember, Borkart on the bench with four fouls as the clock ticks. Roby on the attack. Roby, little finger roll and a block! It counts and one for Isaiah Roby! Final run of their own. Cowan holds it. Got it. Patient to get to 10, I think. Now the play comes. Here's Watson. Watson high off the window. Scores over Fernando.
Until it left his hands.
13-point lead for the Huskers. Marcel strong to the basket. Took some contact as well. Shot clock at four. Trueblood runs into a wall and gives it to Roby.
About Trueblood not panicking with the larger bodies descending upon him.
Fernando being that larger body. Ayala, quick release, parries it.
Very few exceptions on both the offensive and defensive end of the floor. Really impressive for the Cornhuskers.
Watson for three. Yes, sir! What a big shot! Cowan for the answer. He did. Anthony Cowan. Back in transition, the Terps. All the way in, nobody there. With foul trouble to deal with, Marcel had a wide open lane. Now Palmer with six on the shot clock, goes to work. Palmer takes the contact and scores on Fernando. Smith, no, gets his own. Cowan wide open for three. Big shot, Anthony Cowan delivers a three. Agonizingly fast for Maryland. Agonizingly slow for Nebraska. Palmer wide open. Three-pointer is up. And it's good! James Palmer Jr. Got to probably foul at this point. Wide open, Trueblood. And Trueblood with a layup. Traffic all over him. And Spencer Cowan three-pointer is good. And Nebraska, with seven players, six scholarship players, are moving on. They'll play Wisconsin on Friday. What a victory for the Huskers. To make plays down the stretch.
You just can't win sometimes. You got to have a feel for your team, and that's why I give him credit for feeling, I guess.
And Iowa off the tip. We'll start with the basketball. Space, then blocked off by Garza. Good pass out of trouble. Moss finding Wieskamp. And Joe Wieskamp.
Baseline pass away.
Moss over to Shalashvili.
Trent Frazier's got to get up on that, make sure everybody's aware.
Here's Moss driving inside. No, Cook, yes, with the follow. What a start for Iowa.
Great defense.
Goes super with the steals. Ahead, Bishanashvili. Fourth Illinois turnover.
This is just energy defense. Of all the guys giving great energy, I feel like Ayo DeSumo seems fresh.
And you wonder back-to-back games if that's not where you really see that accumulate.
Wieskamp to the rim and one.
Versatile four. Not too true stretch four, but a versatile four.
DeSumo out to Jones for three. Yeah, and there he is. That's the Tevian Jones that was at Madison Square Garden against Maryland. Here's Williams, the three, up and down. And Illinois right back within two.
As much as I like Trent Frazier, I also like Andres Feliz.
Oh, DeSumo driving right into the chest of McCaffrey to tie it at 10.
I like him too.
No, everybody, love everybody. Turnover, McCaffrey got in the air, didn't know where to go with it. Feliz,
Frazier, the extra pass. Jones with his second three. Surprised to see the Illini answer and respond, but what I want to see is if Iowa can do the same.
Bear will try, and Bear will deliver. 13 to shoot. Bohannon stripped it away. Good hands by Jordan Bohannon. Here comes Tyler Cook. Full head of steam. Bohannon the open three. Only played 4 minutes against Nebraska in the overtime game Sunday. Luka Garza back out to Bear, looking for another three, and he finds another three. Ten to shoot for Moss, 7-2, 11-0 run. It's up to Frazier, extra pass, Felice, 10 to shoot, nice feed, Bishanashvili breaks the 11-0 run.
And that's what you gotta do, you gotta drive it against the zone. You need to get this game back, you gotta drive it.
Garza, easy for Garza down low. Shot 71% from three and 68% overall against Illinois. They're at 56% to start this one as Illinois answers right back.
It's really whoever can settle in the most defensively.
Extra pass, Daly with the three! Meishi Daly! Bishanashvili found the basketball. Frazier, wide open three. Four at the United States. Bohannon with five to shoot. Freener from the foul line gives Iowa their largest lead. Pretty good balance so far for Fran McCaffrey's squad. The three up for Jordan, and that falls. Aaron Jordan back on the floor with two foul. Clock winding again. One to shoot. Williams, no. Rebound underneath. Bishanashvili got it from Felice and laid it in.
Sumu toeing the line with six to shoot. The floater over Garza. And Illinois back within three.
On the offensive side of the ball. And when Iodesumo gets going, here he goes.
With the steal. Dosumu. Oh, just the lay-in. Iowa has not scored in over 5 minutes after 30 points in the first 11 as Bohannon ends that drought with a deep three. Rebound, Joe Wieskamp, Bohannon, ready shooter, can't get this three. Offensive rebound, the hammer. Well, there's 7 seconds left, Osumo going the wrong way. Now jump, stumbles through the defense, no, but he gets the tip up and in. Opened on a 10-2 run. Illinois had an 11-0 and a 9-0 run. Iowa had an 11-0 and a 7-0 run. And they start off right at the rim with Joe Wieskamp. Four fouls. Dispossession! And Tyler Cook! Yeah. Just stop!
Okay.
Wow. Presented by Auto Owners Insurance.
He put him in the twister! Oh, he put him in the twister and just threw it down! Oh, wow! I still get excited about good dunks.
Osumu, the no-look. Bishanashvili swarmed it defensively. Felice on a good pass from the freshman post.
You got to think they're slightly gassed from last night. Chasing the play for the last few possessions.
Bear off the deflection, able to put it in. Here's Felice, turn to the corner. Cook got a piece. Bear with the board. Cook again on the baseline, threw it away, this time Dosumu with the steal. Dosumu accelerating, showing the speed, the floater falls over the last 22 games. Jones will try to get it going from deep, but he does. He hit two early, that's his first since, and it's a 7-point game.
Rises and fires, he's tough to stop.
McCaffrey will try to answer, and he does. Boy, that's a bonus for Iowa to get McCaffrey hit from deep. Jones, no. Bishanashvili with a rebound. They're trying to go to work. Running through the lane with a left hand.
Yeah, he is so good around the basket. Much stronger, much bigger, quicker footwork. Better jump shot.
Look out. Bear is raining him down tonight. He's third from deep. Sir John Crispin read that promo. People took their televisions out and smashed them with hammers. Kreener with the left hand and the largest lead of the night for the Hawkeyes. Del Pemsel and Jordan Bohannon. It's a pretty good team.
Solid unit.
McCaffrey tend to shoot. Here's Kreener. We're talking about him. And he delivers on a three. Seward, baseline. The skip out. Jordan. The three falls. Plenty of time in this one.
There's
Cook kicks it out. Bear open again. And Nicholas Bear with 14. 25 made threes in two games against Illinois. Bear the lob. Cook the lay-in. Are four today. Four more tomorrow on BTN. Kipper Nichols with the running hook.
Ooh, channeling his inner Xavier Simpson.
I saved myself. Yes, I'm sure you'll get none. Driving again! Tyler Cook is putting together a dunk mixtape tonight. Rebound tipped out by Wieskamp. Iowa's doing it all right now. Bear, another three.
Next year, they're going to move up drastically in the national rank.
Garza, he'll try to get into the act, and he will.
It's just been a lot. It's a tough team to cover.
That won't go. Kreener the rebound. And the hook.
Now we can get two or three more feet.
Fran McCaffrey keeps that record book in his back pocket, pulls that thing out with a close as Bishanashvili gets to the rim for a two-hand stump. Bohannon against Dosumu. Here's Garza, going baseline, and Garza with seven.
Sitting the defender's body against him, so he knows where the defender's going to be. Seals off very well.
Bishanashvili on the baseline with two more.
What was my answer?
You said, probably, which really didn't make any sense. Inside, the two-hand stuff for Wieskamp, and a chance for one more.
Steve, you know, the producer has control of the replays as Tevian Jones gets to. He can show whatever he wants there. So he just stops the replay.
There's Kreener. Fades away. Bishanashvili got a piece of that one. Dosumu to the other end. A no-look pass to Frazier. And
Frazier now with Seth's second made field goal of the night. Moss driving the scoop. Count it! And a foul. 81-55 with 3.5 to go. Frazier with the scoop. And Frazier with 9.
Last night, Brad Underwood in the postgame show called him energized buddy. He just keeps going. And he's absolutely right. It's as if he doesn't get tired.
Oh. Creamer gets Kane, gets 2. Frazier fading away for 2 more.
With great potential, he handles it well. I think if he develops the shot even more, develops a pull-up jump shot and a step-back jumper.
There's Alan Griffin with the 3. 31 made field goals tonight, ties a conference tournament record for Iowa. 12 threes, the new mark. 25 assists, the new mark. And the Hawkeyes, a record-setting performance in an 83-62 win over Illinois.
That's what makes this Michigan State team so dangerous in transition.
Well, they did fine without him. They went 4-1 with him out of the lineup. Opening tip and a nice save right at midcourt to Wesson, and we are underway.
At this point, I don't think there's any question that they're in the NCAA tournament. They had to win the game yesterday. They took care of business against a very good Indiana basketball team, but a completely different team with Caleb Wesson, and that's why.
And they go downstairs to him for an easy 2. They hand off from McQuay to co-captain. Goins trying to dump down inside. Tillman for 2. Nice move. They stumble, dropping 12 of their final 18, including the 3, without Wesson. Straight on, a lot of iron there, but Woods gets it to go.
Beeline is the new Mr. March. We'll see.
Yeah. Here's McQuay. Great fake. A 2 on the way, and he buries that.
Little things you can build upon to help a guy find confidence on the floor.
Fire it up there and knock it down.
That helps too.
Wearing a pad on that, so we'll see how he negotiates that feeling in the minutes he plays today. Tough baseline shot by Woods, coming up 18 yesterday. Winston, quick drive, tried to hand it off for Ward. Buckeyes in transition. Woods stepping into a 3. Yes. Lawyer way outside. Shot clock a factor now, down to 4. Goins takes a look. He's going to drive it. Going to get a shot in the air. He did in time, and he hit it on the spin move. A lot of attention on the spin. Well defended. In transition, the Buckeyes on the attack again. Quick move inside and 1.
Look at the lineup that's on the floor. This is a lineup we've never seen. I can't think of a time I've ever seen Xavier Tillman, Nick Ward, Kyle Arnes, Foster Lawyer, and Matt McQuaid on the floor.
Lawyer will release. Sam got it. Had time to get off the shot, and he buried it. The 6-foot freshman. Washington gives it up. Jackson's the open shooter. Got it. 3-pointer.
That helps.
McQuay. Callaway. That's a pretty shot from Matt McQuay.
Matt McQuay came in and people just said, yeah, he's a knockdown shooter. See the glass and running in transition. Those are staples of a Tom Izzo team. So many ways, that's their identity.
Oh, pass there, Tillman with the stuff, but the look away by McQuay was a work of art.
Better at expanding his game. He draws so much attention because of his ability to knock down shots.
Listen with the give inside the lane. Heavy traffic, and he made it anyway. Ward with 2.
That is such a tough finish.
Ohio State, the 8 seed. Wesson, no. Got his own. It's blocked from behind by Ward. And the Spartans come away with it. Ohio's got to get a shot in the air. The pass instead. Here's Wesson. Got it. 3-pointer on target.
Great baseline pass.
Oh. Just about tripled up. Great ball movement. Ward is open for 3. Second opportunity now for Ohio State. Wesson way downtown for 3.
Tough offensive lineup for Michigan State right now. No real post presence.
Lawyer again. Oh, he had another one! The freshman from Clarkston, Michigan has been the story for Michigan State, not only from way downtown. Wants that baseline around Washington. Tremendous pass up and in. Get there for 2. Matt McQuay. Winston to push it. One man break. He backs it in.
He wanted a foul, too.
On a 9-2 run.
Good coaches sense it. They feel it. And you got to slow him down when you need to slow him down. Great response.
He's not bashful about getting it in the air. They've hit six of those in the first half. Winston, yes! Starting to become a real factor now down the stretch of the first half after a long sit. Jello. Andre Wesson beyond the three, where he's been dangerous in the first 20. Trying to drive it, swatted away, and he'll stay on this end with 48.7 to go. He'll fire a long-distance shot, and bury it, a two-pointer.
All about finding rhythm.
Winston can be very deadly from the three-point line. Henry with a two. Wesson to Wesson. Andre finding a man on the baseline for the stop. And then Busuccello for two. Woods got a look at that shot clock. It's now down to seven for the Buckeyes. Jackson. Long range. And another one for Wesson. And he was the three-point man in the first half. Ohio State has hit seven threes and six twos. Caleb Wesson will shoot it. He got it, a three-pointer. Well, those are falling for the Buckeyes. Against Wesson, his third. And McQuaid picked up his second foul. Here's Waller. Another one. That's his fourth. He is absolutely on fire. And with all their stars, he has shown the brightest. He'll fire it up again. There's another one. This time a two-pointer.
That is a great set, too. They went screen, re-screen.
Woods. Working on the kid, and knocks it too. Michigan State 5-5. McQuaid tiptoeing in, what a terrific drive for two.
They're going to make a higher percentage.
Caleb Wesson back in. Over to Young. Got his fingertips on it, dropped it in. 38% beyond the three-point line. He's the best for the Buckeyes. Andre Wesson trying to get in tight on Winston for two.
And that's great patience.
Goins is open. Three-pointer had the feet set. All net. Winston sees an opening to bounce for Henry. He connects.
Aaron Henry is one of the best in transition.
Jackson with a bounce speed. Young. Here's Jallo's three. Got it. That was sweet. Boy, did they need that.
You get that mismatch. Cassius Winston defending the post player. They've got good stuff out of him.
Winston turns, fires. Got hit. And he made the three-pointer as well. Big rebound by Tillman. Just named the Big Ten sixth man of the year. And it's Henry for the stop. Ward with a shot clock at four. Looking to get in tight. With that left hand.
I'll tell you, he's still shooting with great confidence and just doesn't go away easily. You think you got control of it, but you have to take care of your body and rest.
Henry, another drive for two. He's been leading the break. Ward on the back down. On Young, spinning. Boyer will swing it. Goins will fire it. Got it! The triple. Spartan fans, every time he gets open, chanting for him to shoot it. Tillman with a shot clock down to two, lay it in.
Ooh, he's drawing a defender, and it's making them play straight up, which is creating space and opportunity for everybody else.
Well, you know how teams prepare as well as anybody as Woods hits the shot. Really struggling today, isn't he? 16 points, 7 rebounds, 5 assists. Jackson opens up the three, look in, knocks it down. And stayed under a minute to go. And of course, the Buckeyes can prepare for an NCAA tournament. Certainly feels that way. They've cut this one to 10.
I mean, friends and family, maybe. It's not to take anything away from him. It's not that he's not capable. You don't get a scholarship to play at Michigan State. You don't sniff the court.
Washington to get a shot in the air. Spins it in. Under 10 seconds. This is a 5-point game. Washington again on a hard dribble. Loose ball. Precious seconds ticking away, and that's it. Michigan State pulls it out. 77-70. And for Tom Izzo, 600 career wins.
Wisconsin coming in 22-9, Nebraska 18-15 after two wins here in Chicago.
At times this year, because the expectations were so high, you saw them get down easily. Well, now since the expectations have been lowered, as Khalil Iverson gets a tough one to go and over top of Isaiah Rope.
On the dribble, Reavers. Iverson again. Yes. Iverson again, a lot of touches early. Half to the other side of the iron for two. The five scorer in the Big Ten. Nifty feed now leaning in for two is Reavers. And a timeout. Miles had lost the jacket about a minute ago. He's up against Happ here and trying to clear out. That's a pretty move to get around him.
Well, that was kind of an Ethan Happ move, a little up and under.
Entry for Happ here, nothing there. Nearly taken away. Here's Reavers to the deck. Airborne banks it in. Now it's down to four. And he right in front of the shot clock buzzer. That'll go down for Drew Blood.
He kept his dribble alive and dribbled away from the play.
Austin shredding the D. Stuck back in. Work right there, the 6'8 seed to finish it. Assists a game. Six on the shot clock. Trice with a bounce, half the man up at the clock, and just rolled on in, and tipped in his own miss. Tim Miles, I think, would agree with you right about now. Wisconsin with the ball. Ford right into the ball game, and extends this to the largest lead now for Wisconsin.
He's not making shots. I know that sounds kind of redundant, but the truth is, when he misses, he struggles.
Watson's pull up. Yes. Oh, wow. He is seeking that shot, he gets hit, and he made the three-pointer. Well, you're exactly right.
Happening on the surface, but what you don't see is the little rhythm that a guy creates for himself, having a certain bounce and a certain swag.
Palmer has been very quiet in the early minutes. That's not good news for Nebraska.
Part of it is Wisconsin does a good job eliminating transition. They're going to force you to execute here, make tough shots like Lynn Watson has in the past two possessions.
Reavers looking in. Looking on that baseline. Iverson swatted away. Roby got another hand on it. No foul on that play. Davidson, he can nail that three-pointer as well. Baseline. Tough shot. Reavers for two.
Can have in front of him. He's going to be asked to do a lot more. And you can see a difference in the way they attack offensively.
That's a big time. That's move. A nifty spin for two. 30 against Creighton, 29 against Seton Hall. Had some huge games this season. Poked away, Roby, very active defensively. Stuck it in through the foul, too. They'll be at the line for a three-point play.
NBA scouts have been saying this is a guy that we're keeping an eye on. The key for him now is production. It's expected that your junior year, you can do more than just have potential.
Wisconsin, a couple of turnovers in a row here. Palmer airborne with a back shot. Trice trying to penetrate. Inside, got it free there for Reavers. He knows what to do with it.
To do that, get layups.
Put on about 25 pounds between his freshman and sophomore years. Another pretty shot there by Palmer leaning in. Half comes away with it, the All-American. It's become a four-point game. And straight on, nice touch by Davidson. Iverson with Roby pounding him. They've got five to shoot. He's going to fire it. Line drived it in. Very confident looking shot by the senior. Iverson. Baseline. Boy, that's a tough shot. He made it to the other side of that iron. Iverson has 10. So he's staying hot. They're doing this without half. He's been on the bench for a long stretch. Watson knocks back a three. When they've needed a big shot, he's hit it.
That's a big answer.
Watson getting 13 a game. Working on half there. Ooh. Roll that one in. That was sweet. Watson set a good first half. And that continues with a big three there to cut it to a five-point game.
Really thrive in a situation like that. It's hard to defend. We've seen that from Penn State at times. They just go one-on-one isolation, and that's one of the toughest things to defend.
Well, talking about tough, Iverson
appear as if they get tired, because it hasn't appeared as if they got tired yet.
Certainly hasn't. Roby airborne. Got it. That was a very nice gesture.
The funny thing is, I'm assuming that I would be one of the heroes.
Roby. Oh, a block. Wow. Big time stuff by Reavers.
You watch Glenn Watson break a guy down and hit a tough fadeaway jumper, your team gains confidence. When you watch James Palmer Jr. do what he does and Isaiah Roby knock down an open three in the corner.
They pulled it within two. Here in our second game of the Big Ten tournament this afternoon. There's Reavers. Yes, with an answer. Ethan Happ remaining on the bench. Those 2,000 career points. Here's Iverson. Spinning. Oh! Tough move. And Roby denies. Clock now at six. Roby scooped it up. And stolen away. Up to the top, Iverson. Followed up, up and in by Pritzel. On either side had scored for 2 minutes before that basket. Watson sticks it. 3-point game under 15 minutes to go. Iverson lines it up. Yes.
The energy just seems to be flowing their way. Wisconsin's been back on their heels, and understandably so.
Watson again with a triple. And he has pulled them to within two.
Wait for the doubles. Read it. Get yourself a good look. That's a good one.
Pritzel. King of the follow. Oh, he's so athletic. Kobe King, the freshman for two. 4-point lead for Wisconsin. 11 and a half left. Yes, with a three.
Struggle to move the ball in a way that you can attack.
Palmer trying to give them the lead and does it last. Trying to make a move, lost it. Back up top, Reavers lining up a three. He backs it in.
As if they're not worried about whether it does or not. That's what makes him so dangerous right now.
Davidson gets free, got a little breathing room, and he knocked it down. He's a long way away, working on Watson. He'll fire it. Boy, that was in the cylinder. Ford won it back and scored. I'm trying to shovel the pass. He gets it to Trice. He hits it. Great pointer on target.
Anybody out there that can do the ice water in their veins? Number one's Jordan Bohan. I think Demetri Trice might be the other. Wow, Glenn Watson. Okay, add him to the list.
Half. Another turnover for him. Watson scoops it up. 7 turnovers for him. And another basket for Watson with a 3-pointer.
That's been part of the problem.
Ford, mid-range, yes! Feathery touch. Iverson gave it up. Boy, they turned it over a lot. True Blood, he connects. And it is back to a 2-point affair. Here's Trice with it. Shot clock to 10. He'll launch. Got it! Big, big shot for the Badgers.
Without having the personality of Tim Miles, who just empowers and makes his players feel confident, and they want to keep it going.
And we'll take a timeout. And it back. Watson with the fake. That clangs away. Comes right to Palmer for two. And the final seconds. So the Badgers. Palmer with a 3.4 to go. Badgers leading by 4. And that'll do it. Wisconsin is on to the semifinals. Greg Gard and the Badgers knocking out Nebraska.
Boilermakers. It's always that question, Raph, when you get to a Friday quarterfinal when the best teams on the top and a throwdown on the lob. Set up beautifully. Murphy.
Well, just getting started. His arms misses with the left hand.
Yeah, going back to that right shoulder. Nice run by Drew.
Good look by McBrayer. He finds Oturu, the big man, running the floor. In his Providence days, or his FIU days, or his diaper days.
Diaper as well. No diaper needed there. A little lingerie.
Dupree McBrayer. Two-man game with Oturu. Now Kalcher. Great shooter. Pulls up. Shakes his man. Knocks it down.
He does have great technique. You're right.
Edwards. Lost the handle. Excellent defense. Coffee running the break. Three on two. Gives it up. And Murphy. Two-handed jam.
What a great decision. He looked him off, too. Looked left. Delivered right. Eifert, I think, is going to get some three-point shots if he keeps busy because Murphy doesn't want to go out and guard him.
Good nice catch. Climb. And the reverse from William. Ran the entire baseline and was able to find the open man. But on the other end, Oturu runs the floor. He is fouled. Chance at a three-point play for the Gophers. Wheeler gets his first minutes of the game as well. Shot clock at 8. Here's Wheeler into the game. Knocks it down. That's a good
from that high-low. Pretty good passer.
Oh, my goodness! Taking the contact and a two-handed jam.
Arms didn't want to get involved in that one.
Another look at our BTN standout presented by Auto Owners Insurance on both ends.
Boy, showing some toughness, too.
Such a great rebounder. That's a great example. He can handle some contact. Long-range three for Klein. Buries it.
Got some range, doesn't he? What I like is improved his ball handling skills.
A little hesitation on Harms. Harms certainly disrupted the shot.
Nice run by the big guy.
And Harms with a jam.
Get out of Harms' way. But just kept working. Great enthusiasm.
I asked Matt Painter if he has adjusted. He's wide open. Great look from Klein.
Yeah, that's what happens when you screen and make yourself available.
He's almost running himself out of his wind in the first few minutes. Uh-huh. Said he's grown up since then. And they're better with him in the starting lineup. As Kalcher, a deadly three-point shooter, knocks it down.
Long run, Purdue's thinking of. You know, a couple of days expecting, I'm sure. Playing the next couple of days.
Offensive board. Williams goes strong to the hole.
Wide body. Comes in handy.
Purdue bench has been excellent. There's Coffee. Got the little floater to go.
He's
got to
look more for himself. It'll open up things for others.
Clock down to 9. Coffee with Edwards on him. Here's Murphy now on the take. The spin. Murphy. The jump hook is good.
That's his game. He's got to attack. Be in that mode. Nice replace.
Harms got good position. Harms scores.
Went over that. How about that?
Wanted to come to Purdue specifically to improve his big man skills, big man youth. Kalcher for 3.
Oh,
off the window.
A reward. Not attacking. It is that double they like to do.
Kalcher gets free. Knocks it down. Well, he's got that? A quick release. Beautiful stroke.
Biggs do a nice job with the dribble handoff. He gets right in the low box area after smart play and player.
Sweet spot for Matt Harms.
And they really control McBrayer, too. He's pretty good driver. Can make that mid-range and step out.
Coffee. Little step back three is good.
How about that?
Coffee can't shake Eastern. Oh. Great defenders and turns it over. You just saw the greatness of Nojel Eastern defensively. Now Wheeler. Oh! Wheeler! Explosive to the rim.
Wheel and deal. He anticipates, but it's all Eastern's containment. The dribble drive, wheel and deal, and bring it strong. Bang!
Take your spirit away in a hurry. And that's what Matt Painter asked him to do day after day. Coffee. Eastern with right with him, but he hits a tough shot.
Well, he was looking for a foul as well.
Williams gets it back, looking for help. Wheeler took it away from Klein. And now Klein knocks it down.
Boy, he didn't need much room either. Very impressive. Makes it easier to get ready for games.
Here's Wheeler. He's fouled and scores with the left. Got the contact from Murphy. When you're talking to an official.
You add something to the discrepancy. In other words, nice dive and finish. Bang!
How about that? Nice read of the double.
Murph!
Turo, the freshman. Kauscher, the freshman. Both from Minnesota. Played together AAU. Here's Coffey all the way in. The reverse is good. The steal. Defense turning into offense for the Gophers, and they're up three.
Nice jump in that passing lane. Set it up.
8 points on turnovers. Minnesota has three steals. Edwards now. This is what you want to see.
Yeah, that's it. That's his game.
The team, the school, and the community in Minneapolis, and really the Big Ten community, has rallied around McGrath. What a finish by Carson Edwards, and ends up on his feet in a stare down. There you go, Murphy.
That's just amazing.
The held ball was the call. Possession arrow for Purdue.
Nice
inside
roll.
The arm. Oh, good look.
How about that? The ability to move by Ryan Klein set that up.
It's been a nice combo, and you certainly have to respect the quick release of Ryan Klein. Murphy taking on Hans. Nice pass and a finish by Oturo. The big men passing to each other.
Nice recovery though by Wayne.
Williams with the deflection. Eastern all the way. The reverse is good.
Well, when he gets a head of steam, he is some.
This tournament moves over to CBS. Murphy spins. Murphy patient and scores with a jump hook.
That's twice now. Barrett has been waiting for a kick out.
In pursuit of a double-double. Klein and threw it right to Murphy. Wasn't there that time. Murphy handles well and finishes with a bounce.
How about that in traffic, too?
Winning yesterday. Looking like a team in better rhythm in this Big Ten tournament. Eastern, and it's blocked by Mott Stockman. Eastern gets it back, steps on the baseline.
Find some more offense. Generally, that's Ryan Klein.
Klein, patient. Klein takes on Stockman. Able to score the basketball. That was impressive. And almost to steal Stefanovic. Plenty of time. 14 on the clock. Coffey now. The lefty goes. And oh, what a finish. Amir Coffey hangs in the air. Coffey with 15 on 5 of 8 shooting. And Harms with the layup.
Pretty. Wide open middle. Nice little dive, but a big guy. And 16 weak side.
That layup stops a 9-2 Gopher run. Murphy using the body. O'Toole's down the offensive board and a quick back.
Well, they are playing with some spirit, aren't they?
Edwards back on the floor and back on the box score as well. He needed to see one go through. Purdue down 9, Eastern on the drive, off the window.
Well, he is both strong and quick.
Edwards has made the only three in this half. Edwards can't finish it. Eastern is there for the putback.
Terrific rebound that kid is.
Just ask that you don't deter others from doing their jobs.
This is that high-low they like to run.
Murphy, quick release on the jump hook.
And they took away the spin move wisely. Need many shots either. That'll be a pleasure to play with.
You know, Minnesota played overtime last night against Penn State. There's a finish by Eastern, a foul, and one.
On Eastern, he's got to keep him off the glass, though.
Here's Klein, gets it from Harms, knocks it down. Ryan Klein delivers the three ball for the Boilers.
Doesn't need much space.
Got to get going a little bit. Dupree McGrath can get the bounce. Harms with the rebound right to Edwards. Pulled it right off the rim. Now Edwards on the drive. Edwards got it. 1.5 to go. Murphy patient. Working on Harms. Got the ball in his hands an eternity, and he turns it into two.
Harms was counting to three there.
I mentioned they played overtime last night. They are heavily dependent on their five starters. Coffey, yes!
How about this?
The Minnesota bench has only played 20 minutes tonight. No points. Edwards falls down, gets the pass to Eifert, who scores.
How about making the dive and timing it beautifully?
Eastern. McGrath on it. Finds Klein. Long range three is up. Hey!
Look at that! How about that?
Travion Williams. Looked like he wanted to pass it. Don't reward the flop. 14th lead change as Williams puts the Boilermakers up two. Does Minnesota have an answer now? Coffey splits a double team. Coffey on the take. Yeah!
and it's in.
How about the way he split that? What a read.
Coffee with 22 yesterday at overtime. Here's Edwards now. No. Williams offensive board.
Kick out.
Jump hook.
He had Klein set up outside.
I've got in front of Harms. He could have gotten that rebound. Coffee gives it up. Now Murphy on the take. Puts the shoulder into Harms. Count that. And one for Jordan Murphy. That's so many great games in this tournament already. This one holds up. Here's Harms. Murphy leads his feed. Harms scores.
Well, they are so effective with him presenting himself.
Edwards turns the corner. Counts it right on him for the tap for the lead. No. And it's Coffee with the board. And Minnesota has advanced to the semifinals of the Big Ten tournament.
Mazdakis and, of course, Matthews, who is playing terrific basketball.
Ready to tip it off here. The final game of the quarterfinal round of the Big Ten Tournament, Iowa Control. 136 live telecasts we've had in the men's basketball schedule on BTN. And Tyler Cook gets the first one. Starting to shoot the three a little bit. A floor spacer, a big man.
He's getting good shooter. Nice dunking. Carson does a great job sealing these guys. Takes advantage of size. Mazdakis disarmed.
They got hot from behind the arc, and it's been one of the rare blowouts we've had in this Big Ten tournament. The only one decided by more than 6 feet. Simpson.
Nice little catchable pass by Simpson. Comes to mind at West Virginia. Screen, roll in the middle of the floor. Everybody's got to be attentive at the shooters.
That was a 75-63 loss. Here's Garza again. A little mid-range is true.
Nice little drift to the corner, too.
We'll get it organized now for the Wolverines. Michigan at 26-5 this year. And there's Mazdakis in Michigan's last game. There's a steal by Poole. Simpson runs the floor with a pull all the way in and scores the layup.
Well, he does it so easy. That pass and lay. Good anticipation and off to the races, too. The rest, innate talent. He was contrite. Such an emotional game to begin with.
Here's Poole for three. Boy, that look familiar?
Oh, goodness.
Iowa needs an answer.
He's in the size there.
Garza. Yeah.
They really read things well. That's a tough match. Nice duck in.
Yeah, they're feeding the big man, Iowa. And Teske knocked it away. Third turnover for the Hawkeyes.
Put it on the floor.
Up top. Teske finishes.
And that's all because Garza.
It's a 10-2 run they're on right now, the Wolverines. What a start for him. No rust whatsoever. That's with the right hand. He's a lefty.
That's what they have to do.
Play with Jason Tatum in his prep days in St. Louis. Simpson wide open for three.
Oh, who does that? What a package.
Only missed two shots. 6 of 8 to start this game. Moss passed it up. Moss a little mid-range is true.
Tough. Great pull-up game that kid has.
In the corner, coach's son. And it's an offensive board. Wieskamp.
Well, they really get out on the shooter, don't they?
Here's McCaffrey again. He's fouled. Count that. Ryan Kreider with the left.
Boy, nice job. Really worked patiently. But his own has had its impact, though. Slowed this club down a little bit. Not really prying.
Brooks. Yes.
How about that?
That was sweet. Shot clock down to 10. Mazdakis left wide open. Now he's on the take. Kicks it. Livers. Got to get one up. Shot clock at 5. Nice.
Nice pull out. Big time.
Tyler Cook goes to the hole. He can finish with that left hand. It's his strong hand.
Sure can.
Michigan probing. Finally, Simpson gets in there. A little floater. Oh, is that hook? What are we calling that?
That's a little hook.
And shoulder length.
Improvised nicely. Nice duck in by Garza. He's very good at that.
Garza knocks down the little mid-range. Never took the ball down. Garza keeps it alive. Garza blocked by Teske. Iowa has three back. Brooks on the drive, gives it up, and Teske rewarded on the other end.
Bending over big time. He's about 6'2 now.
Cook again, drives. Cook scores on Teske.
Once he flashes.
Livers springs free.
Well, that's wide open.
Now Teske clearing some space on that Michigan bench.
And they moved two chairs for him.
Here's Livers again. Oh, he's got the hot hand. Yeah.
They got some athletes on the floor right now, this Michigan.
He wanted Livers to do a little dive to the rim.
Kick it. Matthews finally gets one to go. His first. With six turnovers, they find their big man Garza. Garza gets a rebound and finishes for himself.
Well, that's when they're playing small on a nice read. Fran's got his guys dumping it inside.
Garza, the lone Hawkeye, in double figures with 10. 9-point Michigan lead. Livers. Oh, here it comes.
Wow.
Leader is Simpson, but they can beat you in a lot of ways.
They spread the wealth.
Garza able to get the corner. Garza with the left.
They just can't play him inside all this silly stuff there.
Shot clock at 6. Simpson jabs, fires.
He tempted him and he took advantage. Oh, look, we hear the ball screen.
Rozdakis had a quiet first half. Gets it to Poole. He's fouled and it goes.
It's a defense that gives a lot of things up. I think he hides the baseline.
Eli Brooks tests the ball. Inside, outside. And it's Rozdakis. Simpson gives it back. Ball's popping well. Brooks. That is a stroke.
How about that? Perimeter passing.
Well, this is crunch time right here for the Hawkeyes. Michigan has the pedal down. Moss, that's a big bucket for Iowa.
He has really shown a little personality.
That was Iowa's first made field goal of this second half, by the way. Their points have come at the line.
And a nice little
screen. And one. Brazdakis will try to make it a three-point trip. They went on a 22-2 run against Michigan in their victory over the Wolverines this year. No Teske answers.
Not going to have any burst garden like that, though.
Wisely pulls it back.
He's doing such a good job establishing that pivot foot. Nice slip again. Oh, total breakdown.
With the hammer down.
And they are pushing it now.
Simpson. The hook. Yeah, there it is.
Off the wrong foot.
Greener with the board.
Ooh, hook just ran over it. Simpson.
Hook missed it. And the putback. Iowa needed that, including the win over Michigan. They beat Iowa State, went on the road and beat Penn State. And that road win in Indiana. Here's Livers. Too easy.
Simple.
Offensive rebound after the missed free throw. Here's Cook now, banging his way in. Castleton knotted up as Cook scores at the rim. Make a little run here Wednesday and Thursday.
Hopefully getting hurt there a couple of weeks ago. Tim had a little trouble going off the floor the other night. Right with that little spot. Barrett does the right thing, sliding on that bumper. They got an easy goal.
Jordan Poole hangs. Can't finish. Rozdakis is fouled and one. Great Tom Weirod with that nugget. SID at Michigan.
Big Tom.
Wieskamp. And Poole let him go, and Wieskamp scores the layup. After 12 made threes last night, we're still over. Kick it. Shot clock at 2. Poole goes and had it swatted by Bear. Oh, Wagner leading them to 4 in 4 days. That one hits the rim, sets the shot clock, and a score for Isaiah Livers. There was less than one on the inbound.
Wagner fan.
Is that right?
Yeah, well, I'll fill you in a moment.
Matthews in transition. Jordan Poole. Michigan beat Iowa last year in that run of 4 in a row. Finally a bucket. Michigan 6 of their last 9 occasions. But it is all Michigan here tonight. Simpson back on the floor. Can they get him that assist? Rozdakis is fouled again.
We did not see the real Iowa team tonight.
Well, they will have another day to shine as Greener with the layup. T.J. Baird. Okay, he'll take it. He will take it. Nicholas Hobbs, number 6, scores 8 points this year. Well done. Their first made 3-pointer.
Nice pass to Julius.
You think this guy's ready for March?
I think that's his time of year.
The Wolverines are now 18-3 in the month of March since the 2017 season.
Right after that game, they had a missed, and of course, re-evaluating of their offense. He's back and gets stepped in open looks.
So disciplined, sticking to their principles on the defensive side.
A little drive and replace, high screen, and a
a little three to get this started. Goins hitting the shot.
Give his team some confidence shooting the ball better this year from the perimeter.
To Jim's point, and this kid's been really shooting the ball well too. McQuaid and a Texas, one of your home states of many. Jim,
I'll claim it. I'll claim it with pride. Career win coming yesterday. Winston.
How about this kid? Really lighting it up. Brings a smile even to Tom Izzo during the game.
Michigan State legend.
He was the assistant then. Tough entry there by Reavers.
Tough start for the Badgers. As Hat. Finally, it's Wisconsin on the board.
Wisconsin score. This is a different team. They got to ring the bell. Help others.
Goins. It's another one. Couple of threes by Goins. Here's Davison. McQuaid on his back. Fade away. Goes. The leader of this team, according to Coach Gard, since he was halfway through his freshman season. Winston driving around half. Oh, high off the glass.
Terrific three-point shooter, Reavers. Nice cross.
Look at Winston go.
Measure with the ability in traffic. Get a little lingerie on the deck. That could be a back.
Up ahead.
Lawyer getting those minutes, alluding to that toe prop, but that is deep. How about that?
What a start.
Goodness.
And Ward on the floor for the first time makes a defensive stop. Comes off the hands of Lawyer, though, and into the arms of Thomas.
He's so good at drawing fouls as well down low.
Ward. Look at that. Look at that touch.
Ooh, soft delivery. That's why Pretzel's on the floor. He's a good outside shooter.
Here's King also seeing first action.
Oh, pretty.
Beautiful move.
Nice little subs here. Get a little life on this club.
Henry back on the floor for Michigan State. Defending here.
I like what Greg Gard put a little life on the floor now.
Gets beat. Kobe King.
3 seconds it took him to get in the offensive end. Nice slip.
Ward underneath. Kicks it back out, swing it around, launching three. Yes, Henry, but not shooting, only 31% before that one.
They had a play set. King just went too fast.
Blocked by half.
Here he goes, very good with the ball. Great free throw shooter. He can make shots. He's going to be a nice player.
Here's Henry.
Nice pass.
Around inside, and Tillman with the two. And a foul. Played for Dean Smith at North Carolina.
Can't top that.
Here's half. Tough shot. Was able to get it around Goins.
Look at this versatility. Big guy bringing the ball up the court.
Take a little hook.
Why not?
Why not, yeah.
And hits it.
Jump a little stagger out top. Nice pump.
Wade drives in. Has it taken out of his hands. As Winston back on the floor. Puts it on his hip. Now waiting to try to get a shot. And hits it.
Patience. Tough kid.
Yep. We'll double up. Kick it outside and the three. First of the game for the Badgers. Kobe King. And he's sent to the bench here coming out of the break.
And legal, don't you think?
Yeah. Pretty drive. He had his position.
He's given him some life. Solid, whether it's the deep one or attacking the rim.
Here's Winston. Showing no effects.
Put look good right there.
But they don't impact your transition D much. So you just got to be solid. You can get good shots. At least you can run the offensive glass as well if you're Michigan State. The swing. There's a little horn set, cross screen.
Tough shot. Half is there in the right spot for the easy basket. And Michigan State clears.
Watch the wing.
He likes this shot. McQuaid hits it.
Winston, look. He just points over. He knew.
Side Trice over Winston.
There you go. That's for you, Grant. Value each possession if you're Wisconsin. Oh, don't give up shots like that.
That's Henry.
No contest out there. Same play.
Here's Hack.
There you go.
Time he got Goins falling asleep right there. Hat, nice spin, finish.
Love that little horns look, little dive.
Back to half. Oh, and that's Goins, who rejects it.
Defensive interference right there.
That is three on Ward.
Nice spin and finish.
Davison draws the foul as well.
Game better without Ward, by the way. Would you agree, Grant?
Yeah, he's still rusty, working on his timing.
Look at this.
Tillman. What an assist. It's going to be the sixth assist of the game by Winston.
Well, it's so tough because Winston does so much for his team.
And count it.
He is so good. Patient in that lane.
Tell you what, Wisconsin has switched that screen around. Great buddy ball inside, high-low action.
Winston, jump shot. Got it.
Well, they didn't play that well at all, did they? A dribble exchange.
And practiced every day against Kaminsky on that 2015 Final Four team. Here he is moving inside, and he's able to put it up and in. Winston driving and converting.
Clever. He is so good. This is where things really slow down, too. As effective as he is. Look at him work, though.
Little hook shot, yes.
Unbelievable.
But to your point, the ball's in his hand so much, it's hard to get a rhythm if you're playing with him because you don't touch it as much.
Shanann, yes.
Nice pass by Hap. Great guard about their relationship.
Game is down to six. It's Winston.
That's when he gets hot.
Puts it right back up to eight.
A little misdirection offensively to get Iverson in the post. Great position.
Nice step. Oh, he could have the up and under it. He got hurt a little bit.
Yeah, he landed awkwardly. Points. Wow.
And Hap was out there too, contesting.
Michigan State, though, just can't really find a rhythm offensively right now with him on the bench.
Nice pass. Tillman from Henry.
He heard you. There's your rhythm.
He looked over, too.
There's Winston.
Bro, why'd you back off defensively? That's like a bowl of Wheaties for that kid.
He ran about 90 seconds off the clock for that possession. Dreis hits at the other end.
Wide open, but late.
And there's McQuaid.
Late. Read it, but too late.
Tillman underneath.
Boy, they picked that apart beautifully. Agonizing for the defense, but boy, efficient on the offensive end. Nice cut.
And timeout, Wisconsin.
That's a great skill set.
2 years ago, Mr. Basketball in the state of Wisconsin.
Nice cut.
And Hap gets two.
Look at this defense. Short.
Iverson underneath, lays it in. 10, sixth man of the year. 17 and 7. 13 points in the second half. And that basket will count. 5 seconds to go. A never in doubt outcome in some ways. Boy, Michigan State started this game. Scored the first eight, led by 17 in the first half. Tap control by Oturu, and the Golden Gophers with the first possession.
Really gave problems to Purdue yesterday, Carson Edwards.
There's a three-point shot, yes!
He knows how to get open.
Mastankas
wasn't accepted our house.
Jumper, good for Minnesota. Oturu.
Boy, that's nice to see. Got to use the left hand when you get in there.
Poole driving in, left hand, and it drops.
And I like Poole when he's not settling.
And then Michigan returned the favor on the Golden Gophers' home floor.
This pace favors Michigan now.
As Poole to the hole. And Grayer got stuck. Now Murphy.
There's that spin he loves.
Gets the soft roll.
What a power player. He's amazing, right?
He really is.
Now cool. Nice driving.
Look at this footwork.
Beautiful move.
Oh, oh my goodness.
A nice little hesitation to Steve Smitty. Finish at the rim, Michigan.
Gonna go to Coffey, gonna slash. Nice. It's cool to commit and hits the shot.
It looks like our open, doesn't it? Knifes his way into traffic.
Shut off, gets it to Poole. Matthews again, baseliner, yes.
That'll get him going a little bit. He does have a nice mid-range game. Pretty good driver.
Nice on the way.
Breyer. Oh,
what a shot.
Yes.
He took a shot, too. Lakers looked good last night, too. Made some shots. Great size.
Coffee turnaround, yes.
Well, he took him to school a little bit there.
Simpson.
Pretty clever, isn't he?
Froze the defense like he was going to pass to the corner.
This before it, though, was Simpson driving.
And just that, you're right. Everybody thinks he's got a coffee bit.
McBrayer, little switch off here.
Four. Nice cut.
Hauschur able to convert.
What a nice dive. Good recognition.
And able to manufacture baskets.
Brooks handling the point. Over to Livers. He hits the jumper. That's a two. Real quick over to Tracy. Iggy steps up with the two.
Oh, my goodness. That's not really good defense. That's right on his left arm.
Minnesota's all-time best in rebounding. Coffey has it stripped away for a moment by Poole. Simpson then up ahead. Razdeikas.
Ah! Are you going to see the muscles? It's too early.
Gordon Murphy needs to touch the basketball. Too many possessions where he hasn't been involved. Too important to this team.
Turu able to squeeze it through. Poole.
What a step back that is. Good.
Oh, and he banks it home.
And rewarded for a tough shot. That's not fair. The other end with Murphy really stood him up great.
Now driving.
Oh,
well done.
Wow. Pretty impressive.
Simpson. He knows how to put it just right above the window pane. Livers. Quick pass to the basket.
What a setup by Simpson.
Timeout, Minnesota. 31-2 on the year.
Fantastic. Kelvin Sampson, the job he's done with that program.
That is Simpson with the three.
Minnesota doesn't have a chance.
Their individual D is so good. Look at this footwork by Matthews.
Tough shot. Boy.
Is right.
Matthews.
Love that right there for Charles Matthews. No hesitation, indecision.
Last year's national finalist team, which was pretty stellar defensively, gave up five more a game than this bunch. Here's Teske. He'll take it. Oh, and a dead ball three.
A squisher.
Very impressive considering they don't have great depth.
Look at that footwork.
Livers almost got the steal forced. Murphy able to float in and get the bounce. And then on to the championship game. We're going over. Beat him. Coffey. No. 5 seconds to go and a half. Simpson with one. Puts it up. Yes.
He's amazing. Keeps on ticking. Murphy needs a bigger game if they're going to get back in this thing. Just take over down low a little bit. But this kid.
Simpson.
What do you want? What do you need? I'd like to see them attack quicker. Excuse me, Grant.
There you go.
They go strong.
There he is. Murphy.
That's it.
Now with eight on the game.
A little power ball. Go. That's it.
There he goes. Another one for Murphy.
And this kid is a tough guy.
In part because of Matthews, but also you have to factor in the team.
You've been getting the decap version so far today. A two-row. There you go. They're starting now. Show a little more aggression on this end of the floor.
Now that's their game.
It's in the test game. And look at this. This kid Simpson, though, what he does to make everyone else look good.
Qualities as a player.
Breyer hits the three.
I tell you, Michigan is so patient on the offensive end.
Razdeikas.
He's a righty by design, or birth, I should say.
Now Coffey. Good shot.
All of a sudden, they're not wasting time. Dilly-dallying. Here's a little back screen. Here's the back screen lob.
Delivers quickly over to Simpson in time.
Yes! Oh, God.
Wow.
I didn't mean to defame him now. Taking umbrage for a little time.
Livers. And another three for the Wolverines.
Go to the basket.
Teske gets it up ahead. Nice. Simpson. There is Livers.
How pretty.
Two more. And a foul.
of those guys that can be real good and got better too. You know what I mean? Like, this kid is not quite a freshman late run. Would you agree with me? Yeah. Knows what to do though. And he got.
Coffey lost the handle.
Look at this run out.
Up ahead. Livers chases it down and scores.
Did the right thing too.
Coffey.
Oh, wow. Is that a nice move, huh?
Had a couple of baskets here in the last minute. Stakas with two more.
Just stops at the right time.
It's tough, these conference tournaments. Particularly when you're a low seed.
Right, and yeah, you got to play extra nights.
Livers. Big from the outside on this one.
Those two wins help their cause here for the tournament seeding.
Livers. Hey. His third three of the game.
You know, the day off in between, the extra time in the timeouts.
Oturu able to back in and get the basket.
Refresh a little bit.
Those playing two games in 3 days.
Livers. Oh, it's his half.
And Poole knew it.
There's a three at the other end.
Alshire.
Alshire.
A lot of respect for the opponent.
Brooks able to back in Washington and get the basket. It's up and down the floor. Brooks again. There's your whistle and the basket.
That was a good question by him. I like this.
He's got that Bob Knight humor, by the way. Get a little shot there. Assignment. Nice pass.
And a foul on Davis. The basket counts by Omersu. 3-point play included the bank free throw. Coffey slashing to the basket for two more.
I'll tell you, that's one of the reasons they're exhausted.
Ooh. There's Matthews.
Pretty through traffic. Good footwork.
And we can get all set up for Michigan State and Michigan tomorrow here. Coffey swings it around. That's a two-point shot, and it beat the buzzer just in time by Hurt.
Crazy over there.
Rudd. Block. What a block it is, too.
Wow.
That's Brandon John. Going to win it by 27. Big Ten championship matchup is all set. Wolverines in a walk. For the entire day, both were wire-to-wire wins.
I don't think we'll have to worry about that today.
Oborowski, Larry Serrato, Paul Sells, the officials, and here we go, Bill.
Team feeds off him. They must play big on both ends for the Wolverines.
Teske does a great job availing himself.
And the shot drops, yes. Woo. Off the glass, and Winston pushing it up ahead to Henry. Inside, one's no. Woo.
Matthews, big block.
Back to McQuaid for a three.
Good job getting in the lane. This is where he creates problems. Nice duck in.
Into the paint for two. Tillman with the basket.
Good defense there by Henry.
Got some length on him, too.
McQuaid again. He'll try it from the wing. This time, yes.
Don't leave him alone.
Franz Dacus, they leave him open. And he takes advantage.
And you got to put a hand. They got the mismatch with Ward on him. There's that duck in.
Here's Ward, you said, so dangerous on the low post.
Loves to come. He does have a counter now. There's last year, he didn't have that little move.
Back to Ward, he says, I can do this. Just did it. Now, kicks it far side. Henry. Ooh-hoo. What a move.
Oh. Stretch those legs out.
Henry, beautiful move. Little ball fake. Froze the defense and gets to the rim. So impressive. I think he can be an X factor for this team. So much potential, so much talent.
Against Ohio State with a career high 14. By the way, Isaiah Livers on the floor for Michigan for the first time. Oh, Barnes comes right off the bench and buries the three. Only Braz Dacus has scored for the Wolverines. There's Livers on the floor again.
Nice dive and pass.
And Braz Dacus has all nine.
Braz Dacus is a little bit winded.
Ward.
He can make that.
He's wide open.
Got a great touch. Really developed his game.
With the foot surgery out for the season. 15 points a game he averaged before out with injury. Look at Winston with a three.
Well, John Beilein was saying the problem with him is he makes threes. You can't hide on the three. That pace that he runs at, deliberate, backs off, step back, jack, nail it with some nylon. Such a great floor leader.
Oh, and he throws it right off Rastakis, but still saved. Simpson off the floor, looking around.
Nice pass
to Poole, and he's got another assist in this tournament.
These two guys, the point guards, have been going at one another forever. Nice slip.
Bounce pass to Teske. Simpson with a beautiful feed. And Teske says, get that out of here. Big Ten's top shot blocker. Simpson.
Oh, clever he is. To protect the ball with strength and then use the rim to ward off.
Feeds it inside and Teske able to squeeze it home.
Trying to influence Bud Floyd. There's so much depth and character with that guy.
McQuaid comes out of the break and hits a three.
Toughness.
Shot by McQuaid after 10 unanswered by Michigan, and Livers banks it home. Irons had come into the game today and right away hit a three. Here's Livers. It's one for Michigan.
He's starting to really perk this kid. I believe Brazdakis stepped in there defensively.
That's perfect.
He's known for his offense. Nice cross.
And Kithier knocks it out.
There he is. This is where he's tough. There's the old-time delivery.
You like that rap, don't you?
Pass the basket. It's a new religion.
McQuaid left alone. Wow, can't do that.
Rastakis just relaxed a little. Not a good closeout.
Different lineup than we're accustomed to. Teske on the bench and the bigs on Michigan State.
They really don't have a center. They don't need one of these. He's going to make those.
Rastakis now with 12 on the game.
Well, they are really off their game. And this is the guy that's got to get in the lane right here. That's his game. He's got to do more of that. Nice play. Teske
gets swiped away.
Nice five.
Far side of McQuaid. He loads up and hits it.
He does a great job with that side saddle. Little pump fake. You bite. One bounce. Drill it.
Really been the only thing going offensively for Michigan State up until now.
Yep. Going back to the end of the first half, he has their last 9 points. Meanwhile, Poole rattles home a three. Simpson wanted to challenge Winston. Rastakis. He'll take a three. And all that. Poole has it stripped away. Henry on the triple drive.
How about the freeze with the ball?
Jump shot, yes. He's Matthews. Points. Still can't get
it. What a rebound.
That's Tillman.
Boys, quick to the 10.
Job on these edges by
nice pass.
Great pass.
Oh, McQuaid. Basket counts. Regular season battles here in the last 3 weeks. Poole. Yes.
Well, he can step back and get them organized.
Both those wins by the Spartans. Second half comebacks. McQuaid.
You can't overhelp like that. What a settle that is.
Yeah, that was McQuaid got a hand on it actually. On the shot.
Watch McQuaid in the corner.
Winston, take it away. The basket counts.
McQuaid, one of the best in the Big Ten.
Four to shoot.
Nice fake. There's your Smitty move.
Again, McQuaid. Oh, my goodness.
What a find. Teske really making people disappear. Nice look.
There's Teske. Oh, he tried to dunk it. It gets two bounces off the rim and down.
Play against these two teams.
Winston.
Two in a row.
This time, though, it works out.
And Livers got a little bit of a shot.
Five to shoot. Livers trying to stay right with him. Tough shot.
Oh, an Indian horse with that delivery.
It's a pull off the board. They've gone scoreless. Michigan for 3 minutes. Teske.
Nice pass.
Oh, that was the way to come right out of the break and do something to change the momentum.
State is only too fast. Nice work by Simpson.
Simpson to Teske. Winston working it hard. Gets around Poole.
And man, you said working hard on that play.
Win it three consecutive years. Simpson inside drives on Winston.
And he refused the screen. Set it up beautifully. Overload replace.
Livers.
Ooh! Showing some onions!
McQuaid.
And here's that horns look. End up with a nice little lob.
Right underneath. Tillman ties it at 60.
He won't give it up, I don't think, Winston. He'll try and get in the lane and be creative.
Here he's driving in. Teske defending. Oh, somehow. Somehow it goes.
Like Teske at the rim a little bit, though.
Brazdeikis into the paint. Trying to tie it. Comes up short. It'll stay at this end.
They're going
to
look at it, though. They had done it with tape.
There you are, your Big Ten champions once again. For the sixth time, it's Michigan State.